Alright, so let's get started. First things first, you're going to need your ingredients. And, well, the most important thing you're going to need is a bread pan. You can't really do that without this. So I think I got this at like Target for like 10 bucks, so it's really not that expensive, and it lasts a lifetime. So. Next thing you're going to need is a bowl to put all your ingredients in, because then your kitchen would be a mess if you didn't. And then you're going to also need your measuring cups. You need a 1 cup measuring cup, a half a cup, and a liquid measuring cup. And then you need your sugar, your flour, raisins. I had a thing of sun-made raisins in the cabinet, so I'll just use those. You need 1 egg. This is a large egg, but I guess regular sized. So you're gonna need caraway seed, and I hope I have enough. You're gonna need caraway seed and baking powder. And you can just get these at A&P, any grocery store really, and buttermilk. And you're also going to need a electric mixer. Okay, so first things first, you're gonna combine your flour, sugar, baking powder, and salt. And I didn't get the salt. Salt, another ingredient you're gonna need. So. Okay, so again, first things first, you're gonna combine the flour, sugar, baking powder, and salt into a bowl, like so. And so you need 3 cups of flour. That's all you need for the flour. Now I'm gonna put this away. This off to the side because we're done with that. And this too for right now. And then you need a half a cup of sugar. So I'm just gonna take my sugar and my half cup measuring thing and just do half a cup of sugar. See, this one's easier because I don't need the knife to level it out. It does that on its own. And it's a lot of sugar too, just saying. And then baking powder, you need 4 teaspoons. So I can push that off to the side. And then we need a half a teaspoon of salt. Now I don't have a half a teaspoon, so I'm gonna eyeball it with the full teaspoon. That's done. Push that to the side because I don't need it anymore. And you're gonna mix this together. Mix it together because since it's not liquidy yet, you don't really need the. While you're mixing all the ingredients, While you're mixing all the ingredients, I suggest you turn the oven on. You're supposed to preheat it to 350. So I've had it preheating for about 10 minutes now. So by the time I'm done here, it should be ready to go. And just give it. And then you're gonna do 1 egg, like I have here. I'm gonna crack the whole egg in, and you're going to mix in 1 cup of buttermilk. And then now you're gonna mix in the 2nd cup of buttermilk, but you're gonna do it 1/2 cup at a time. See, it makes like a doughy texture, and that's after about 30 seconds of mixing it with the electric mixer, and I have it all over me now. And so next, you're going to mix in the raisins and the caraway seeds. So we're gonna do the caraway seeds first. So, and again, I got this at A&P. I've had this for actually a couple years. This is like the 3rd or 4th time I've made this. So yeah, you're gonna do 1 teaspoon of caraway seed. So again, I have my trusty teaspoon here. I think I have just about enough. one handful of raisins, or the way I do it, as many handfuls as you want. So yeah, I did about 2.5 handfuls of raisins because I really like having them in here. So now that we're done with that, we can put that to the side. And so now you're going to take your pan and grease it to take margarine like I have in my hand right now. And you just rub the margarine all over the pan. Just butter that bad boy up. See, now I have a nice kind of even coat of flour. Doesn't have to be perfect. So now you're just going to take a spatula or a spoon, well, a mixing spatula or a spoon, and you're going to pour the mixture into the bread pan. There you have it. There's your mixture in the bread pan. And so now you're going to cook it for 1 hour on 350 degrees. So I'm going to put it in the oven and...
The pipes are calling.
So now that I have my Irish soda bread in the oven, I will see you guys in 1 hour for the finished product. So see you soon. Okay, so welcome back, guys. It's been exactly an hour since the last time I saw you, and the timer just went off on my phone and telling me that the bread is ready. So let's take it out and see how it turned out. So now when you're taking anything out of the oven, use these oven mitts, please. You don't want to burn yourself. It won't be fun. And see, this is your finished product. Hey guys, so I hope you all enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a big thumbs up and make sure you subscribe down below. And also comment down below some of your recipes on how to make Irish soda bread. I hope you all have a happy and safe St. Patrick's Day, and I will see you guys next week.